climate change is real and happening now.
And it's the people that have least contributed to this crisis that continue to suffer the most.
Meetings as usual, negotiations as usual. We are quickly losing our hope in you.
Hello, my name is Charlotte Alman. I'm 23 years old. I'm a climate and environmental activist from Kenya. If you didn't already know, world leaders will be at the COP26 to discuss the threats of climate change on our planet. Climate change has impacted Africa and my community in various ways. One is that it has led to the reduced food supply due to the changing rainfall patterns, which affects the agricultural sector that Africa highly depends on. Here are some of the young climate activists to tell you how extreme weather conditions has affected their country.
Right now, drought has been declared a national disaster and over 2.1 million Kenyans are facing starvation. Climate change is also greatly impacting the education sector, where we have some regions where children are not able to go to school due to the floods that have ravaged different parts of the counties as well.
Je suis originaire du Sénégal. Le Sénégal est un petit pays de l'Afrique de l'Ouest et ces dernières années nous avons enregistré une avancée considérable de la mer, c'est-à-dire les régions côtières. Des populations sont obligées de quitter leur domicile pour aller dans d'autres domiciles, c'est-à-dire on parle pas des déplacements climatiques.
Normally we've got a two-season climate system in Nigeria. We've got the rainy season and the dry season. But recently it's not been the same. Over the past couple of years, there's been a continuous and there is a drastic change in these weather patterns, and something so trivial has gone on to affect farming.
Uganda's temperatures are rising. Seasons are no longer predictable. Our survival depends on farming, but our plantations are being lost every day with displacements, if not deaths, to such disasters.
So, what is it that us African climate activists want to tell the world leaders at COP26?
We need climate action now. No more time for promises. There is no planet B.
This is COP26. And this has been 26 years of talking. We need to stop investing in fossil fuels. And then we need to massively increase nature regeneration. And then we have to put the people that are the most impacted by the climate crisis at the center of the climate conversations.
We need an international crisis team, which will fight climate change catastrophe all over the world, mostly in countries like mine, which are vulnerable to climate change.
Pas normal, faut pas cibler seulement que l'Afrique. L'Afrique n'est pas le seul continent affecté. Il y a aussi l'Asie, il y a aussi l'Amérique du Sud, et aussi les grands pollueurs, c'est-à-dire les grands pays qui sont taxés de pollueurs, doivent eux aussi avoir des politiques un peu plus intelligentes vers ces pays pauvres là. Et je pense aussi qu'il faut aller vers une réflexion globale. Il faut aller vers une solution globale qui prend en compte tout le monde, sans exception.
I haven't got a message for the world leaders at COP26. I think I have more of a question, which is, what kind of a future, what kind of earth do you want to leave for your younger ones? And by your younger ones, I mean your grandchildren or your children.
Justice. What do we want?
Climate justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
Young people take climate change seriously because they fear for their future. So they turn the fear into action to demand change, speak out the ugly truth, and stand up to big corporations because they understand the urgency of climate action needed for the world to stay alive.
In my community, few people understand climate change. It is with these facts I would like to reach out to more African youths to come and join in taking climate action, as Africa has one of the most vulnerable communities to the adverse impacts of climate change. Thank you.